Madam Speaker, may I commence by congratulating you on your appointment as the Speaker of this House. It's a marvelous achievement, and I wish you every success.
Thank you.
I'm profoundly grateful and touched by the great honor accorded to me by the voters of my electorate of Smithfield. And I'm deeply conscious of the historic victory in being elected the first Liberal member for Smithfield as I rise to deliver my inaugural speech. It's my first speech in Australia's first parliament, a speech I never imagined I would one day have the honor and privilege to deliver, a speech that I hope will be as extraordinary as my journey into this place. A journey that started in summer of 1918. At the time, my father was just a teenager and my mother a young child. They and their families were among 90,000 Assyrian Christian refugees fleeing their ancestral homeland to escape persecution. My parents and the other refugees were fleeing from the Ottoman Empire to escape what would be later known as the Armenian, Assyrian, and Pontic Greek genocide. By the grace of God, my parents survived for a reason that they were protected and protected by none other than an Australian soldier, Lieutenant General Sir Stanley George Savage, KBE, CB, DSO, MC, ED. At that time, a 27-year-old captain was selected to join the Dunstar Force, an elite task force assigned to resupplying the Assyrians fighting in Persia. Unable to complete the task due to the fall of Urmia, he persuaded his British commander that he should stay back with the remaining refugees. For 6 weeks, Captain Savage used all the means at his disposal to protect the refugees against the perpetual onslaught of the Ottoman forces, reasoning that the Turkish commander would concentrate on killing him before harming the refugees. He strategically placed his command at the rear of the refugees' procession and deliberately drew enemy fire. By offering his command as a target, even though he was outnumbered 100-1, Captain Savage managed to slow the enemy advance long enough for most of the refugees to flee. This act of courage and self-sacrifice was far beyond what was expected of a junior officer in the field, and Captain Savage was subsequently decorated with the Distinguished Service Order for his efforts on this occasion. Australian journalist, historian, and official war correspondent Charles Bean wrote that the stand made by Savage and his 8 companions that evening and during half of the next day against hundreds of the enemy thirsting like wolves to get at the defenseless throng was as fine as any episode known to the present writer in the history of this war. My parents survived the genocide because of the heroic actions of Sir Stanley George Savage, and I pay tribute to him today in this House as the newly elected Liberal member for Smithfield. My parents, having survived and eventually meeting some years later, married and had 6 children. I was born in 1948 in Habaniya, a small town on the banks of the Euphrates River in central Iraq, and the location of a British airbase, RAF Habaniya, where my father was employed. At the age of 11, my family moved to Baghdad and settled in the southwestern suburbs of Dora, where I completed my schooling. My parents valued a good education, and they valued hard work. They provided me, my brother, and 4 sisters with all the necessities and encouragements to maintain a higher education. I clearly remember the struggle my parents went through to raise us. They instilled in me a sound work ethic and taught me to take nothing for granted. Thanks to them, I went on to graduate from the University of Baghdad in 1970 with a bachelor's degree in science and geology and a master's degree in petroleum geology in 1975. After completing my master's degree, I began working as a geologist with the National Minerals Corporation, where I supervised mineral exploration programs. My parents, Bejan and Pana Rohan, have recently passed on, but I know they would have been proud of their son becoming the state member of Smithfield, and I know they are watching from a better place. I left everything behind, including my teenage sweetheart and future wife, Janet. I arrived in Sydney in September 1979 and settled in the southwestern suburb of Bosley Park in the state electorate of Smithfield. It's where I still live today. Shortly after my arrival, I I enrolled at the University of New South Wales to continue my studies under the supervision of Professor Philip Evans. However, in 1981, I was offered a position with Robertson Research Australia as a geologist in North Sydney. It was an offer I couldn't resist. Fate played a role in uniting me again with my teenage sweetheart, Janet. She came to Sydney accompanied by her father, Andrew Simon, in December 1982, after her family had settled in the United Kingdom a year earlier. We were married at St. Mary's Church in Fairfield in January 1983, and we were blessed with two boys, Sargun Rohan and Luca Rohan. Both were educated in local public schools, and both have now graduated from university and are busy climbing the corporate ladder in their chosen fields. My sons are my pride and joy. I love them dearly, and I'm honored to have them here today with my wife, Janet. I wish to express my great appreciation to the people of Smithfield who elected me to represent them with an overwhelming 20.3 swing on the 26th of March 2011. I know that many of them voted Liberal for the first time in their lives. I thank them for putting their faith in me and the Liberal Party. To them, I make this pledge. I will always put you first. I will dedicate the next 4 years of my term in office to providing to you, my constituents, that your trust in me was well placed. Because for me, first and foremost, politics is about serving people. The said electorate of Smithfield is part of the Greater Western Sydney region and is 135 square kilometers in area. It's a typical working class community. Its boundaries extend from the Western M4 motorway in Greystanes to the Elizabeth Drive in Edinson Park and from South Creek in Erskine Park to the Cumberland Highway in Fairfield West. My electorate of Smithfield takes its name from the suburb of Smithfield, which was originally known as Chisholm's Bush. In 1867, Smithfield was a semi-rural settlement populated by vine growers, gardeners, wood timber cutters, orchards, and tanneries. John Ryan Brennan, an attorney, was appointed police magistrate, named it Smithfield, after the meat markets of London and Dublin. Smithfield has become a thriving commercial center, and the once rural township is now a mixture of semi-rural, residential, commercial, and industrial lands. The state electorate of Smithfield is within the boundaries of the Fairfield, Holroyd, Penrith, and Blacktown City Council areas, and comprises of the suburbs of Abbotsbury, Bosley Park, Cecil Park, Eastern Creek, Edinson Park, Erskine Park, Greenfield Park, Greystanes, Horsley Park, Kemps Creek, Mount Vernon, Prairiewood, Prospect, Smithfield, Fairfield West, and Weather Park. With over 1,000 manufacturing, wholesale, transport, and service firms providing more than 20,000 jobs, the Smithfield Weather Park Industrial Estate plays a key role within the state's economy. During the campaign, I said my priority would be to stop the increasing cost of electricity. The greatest threat of the increasing cost of electricity today is the current Prime Minister and the Labour Party's carbon tax. As a geologist, I know that the Earth's climate is constantly changing owing to the natural variability in the Earth's processes. This carbon tax will hurt local families in my electorate by raising the cost of living even further, and it will hurt industry and investment. I'm opposed to any carbon tax, and I'll continue to campaign against its introduction. The campaign to win Smithfield was not easy. In fact, it was really hard. I was lucky I had a small but dedicated campaign team. Without their help, victory would not have been possible. During the election campaign, we embraced technology, and in particular, social media. In fact, the number of fans on my Facebook page is second only to the Premier's Facebook page. We don't look just under 18,000 homes. We held over 100 street stalls, letterboxed the entire electorate several times, put up hundreds of posters, and called thousands of homes. I thank my campaign team members, Nina Kiwargis, Gabby Kiwargis, Joseph Mirza, Adi Koshaba, Matthew Hanna, Councillor Ross Grove, Doug Khalija, Johan Dariush, Vince Repipi, Stuart Smith, Adrian Pike, Andrew Osman, Elias Shamun, Jamal Elisha, Najah Namrud, Patrick Osman, Dalia Youssef, Vivian Mirza, Dalia Mirza, Ashi Mikhail, Hedra Munshi, Ross and Robert Candelori, Lujana, Johanna, Karim David, and Jackie Wall. as well as my 120-day election day volunteers. All this would not have been possible without their contribution. Special thanks go to the Honorable Anthony Roberts for being so supportive of my during my campaign, thus providing me with an army of volunteers from the Lenkov SEC, whom I'm very grateful. I want to thank Councillor Zaitoma. He was the maestro of this campaign, and to whom I must credit with a significant part of this victory. As my campaign manager, Zaya demonstrated great leadership, strategic thinking, and vision. Zaya spearheaded the campaign to expose the failures of the Labour Party in the Fairfield area over the last 2 years. This has helped convert the once Labour heartland into Liberal territory. I acknowledge Zaya's parents, Yoni and Benjamin Toma, who are here in the public gallery. I thank my staff, Joseph Adams, Katrina Oliveri, Emmanuel Brica, and Zaya Toma, for their hard work and loyal service to me and to the community at large, thus far and into the future. We have campaigned together for many years in the local area, and it's an incredible honor to finally be in the position to be able to serve the community for all of us. And finally, I congratulate all members on their success of their election in this place. I look forward to working with you over the coming term. Thank you.
Congratulations.